We welcome you here live for the Summit Point Sprint here for the iSCAR Road Series, getting set to go green here in a couple of moments. We're setting ourselves up. 44 Logan Clampett going to be starting on the front row. So the order is going to be shown on your screen. Going to go fast. So better watch for your driver and see where he's sitting here for tonight. But this is obviously the biggest field here for MX5. Apologies about the huge delay. I was out having some fun, but otherwise than that, glad to have you here, all in the booth here for tonight, and joining us. So, otherwise than that, nothing really much to explain here. Weather looking nice. I'll go ahead and show that here in just a moment, but yeah, weather currently at 79 degrees, so a fairly mediocre track. 10 turns, 2 miles in length, track elevation around 600 above sea level, track temp 110 as right now. So go ahead, pull up the grid. And your pole sitter. All he needs to do is grid up, and after that, we're going to get ourselves up and away here at Summit Point. There he is, right in front of your screen. Everybody's gridded in here for tonight. That number 44, Logan Clampett, will take it from the go as we go green. This time by, lights out, and away we go here. And Logan Clampett gets a nice restart over that 36 at Clifford Evan. Everybody's going to single themselves out. Coming into one, and look at this pack as they snake down the straightaway. Clampett and Evan, by the looks of it, they're trying to scramble in, coming into turn number one. Hopefully nobody runs themselves over as they're side by side for third place. Everybody makes themselves through fairly nicely. Yeah, there's just three wide action as everybody's trying to get a handle for these race cars right in the background. As meanwhile up front, Clifford, Cam Evan is trying to chase down that 44, Logan Clampett. Anthony Burrows up in the mix as we got a wreck in the background. One car way out of the racetrack. He's going to follow all the way to the tail end, and looks like that would be the 31 of Harrison Chandler. Double wide action as the field snakes through to the low side, one of the Patriot machines trying to get a handle on it. I think that's Connor Brandon, the number 92. There he is, right in front of your screen as 44 Clampett, there he is, right in front of your screen. Whips by the screen. He heads into the 10th and final corner. Right off, a bit off track, but that's fine. One car way off track, though. You don't want that happening as Clampett is going to complete lap 1 out of 22. Looks like Chandler is back on the racetrack. A lot of blinking issues with him. Look how wide Clampett is. Through the corner, top five. Going through, double wide action going on right behind. Looks like Nick Short has pulled himself into 10th place. Kiloa Hankins and the 72 Discord machine fighting out with the green tea machine. Right alongside him, inside. Oh, a bit sideways right there. That would be the 72 Hankins. He's going to go ahead and rally it out straight. We'll lose multiple positions on it, though. They're also battling up front. Dominic Cow sails himself into the corner. That's actually Jonathan Hernandez. And the 16, Nick Delicato, making himself in the mix. Hernandez overshoots the corner, and that allows the 72 Kilo Hankins to get back right back at him. Head down, just about a three car pull away. Burrows, Eben, and Clampett. I pulled up away from fourth place of Derek M. Smith. Again, apologies about the lag. I'll probably fix that here in a moment. You see the big snake all the way back to a green team machine, but fairly even overall as Harrison Chandler. Oh, we got a car sideways and hard into the inside wall. That would be the 61 Dominicao. His day is going to be... Nope, he's going to keep it going. Chandler, I don't even know where he is. Robert Knuckle was also involved in that wreck, so... There's Clampett. There's Evan. There's Burrows. He's actually under attack by the number 8. I mean, that's not Burrows. That's the 66 of Derek M. Smith, Connor Brandon. In the mix of that, and here comes Austin Johnson out of nowhere. Johnson gonna attempt to peek to the inside. Can't make much of it as they head into the corner. Final one. Just a nice sweeping right-hander. And a long front straightaway. Complete lap number 5 out of 22. Let's roll through the field. A bunch of battling going on right behind. Looks like this is for 16th place. William Schmidt, Dylan Simone is going to go at it. What are these cars with? Multiple damage. And looks like it's Poindexter, whose day is going to be done, unfortunately. So... into the corner. A lot of lag, unfortunately. I'll try to fix that coming next time as we get a car off track. Watching currently the 02 of Patterson make himself around the racetrack, but Evan hasn't made as much time as I thought he would on the 44 Logan Clampett, but Clampett's still leading it around. He's probably one of the best here in the MX-5. Obviously won the MX-5 shootout in which he drove an actual MX-5 in real life, so. Clampett with a hosting a 8,000 I rating as he rounds through final corner. But it looks like Cam just slowly losing that 44 of Clampett, and Clampett sort of breaking the draft to prevent them from going up. But meanwhile, you gotta duke out here for fourth place as the 66 of Derek M. Smith has fell back to fifth place. A 5-car pack here as they head into one. Nick Short trying to make something of it. Nick, obviously one of the best road racers on the open wheel side. And you see him all the way, sometimes in the F3 series. He's making a showing out tonight, and he's made himself from the back all the way to 7th place. Probably going to be the driver of the race by the looks of it. He is flying. Lo Hankins, we're talking about him, Dylan Simone, Jonathan Hernandez, Peter Kenny, both of them are fighting it out. There's Brian C. Mullen, Justin Johnson, all these drivers, very fanned out. Robert Knuckle is just about to get lapped here in just a moment, so fairly fanned out field, very surprised. There are 28 people here, by the way, now 26 left on the racetrack. Dominicao and Carson Poindexter are a full DC as down to the front stretch. Clampett can cross the line and slowly pulling away from those from second and third of the 36. Cam Evan and Anthony Burrows. Burrows trying to find a way around. Get an onboard look. Of Anthony Burrows as he heads through the corners. There we go. All right. Hopefully the stream shouldn't be lagging now. Oh, as you see Evan blinking in and out. Yeah, Evan's currently not displayed in front of your screen. Oh, there he is. That was a large blink by that 36 of Cam Evan. But yeah, there we go. Alright, nothing going on right now, so. Bit jumpy. Now it's getting jumpy. Alright, so wide shots is just jumpy, I guess. I'll have to fix that with my graphic settings and turn some stuff a bit down. Scroll through the field. As we're nearly coming to just about halfway. Menchu has rattled himself into ninth place as thank you, Paul, for go ahead and subscribing. Very appreciative. This fight here as looks like Menchu is trying to find a way around that 0-2 of Patterson, but Patterson's currently holding him off as of right now. There's Clampett. Everybody right behind. Nope. Well, it looks like they've found out just a slight. Nick Short has rallied into sixth place from the start. He started all the way in the back, and boy, he is blazing fast in that number 93 machine. So, see right there, some cars, some lap cars in the way, as one of them actually off track. Derek's definitely faster than Connor. Connor's just holding him off as of right now. Same thing goes with 36, Cam Evan, and Anthony Burrows. I think Burrows is a slight bit faster than Evan, and Derek's slight bit faster than Connor, and you see the battle here for fourth. Now heating up as, oh, off track goes the 66 of Derek M. Smith. He's gonna lose some position. Handful amount of track position to Connor. And I'll move Nick Short into the top five. Nate Stewart being displayed in first place. Looks like Stewart's going to be out of it. As they head around, going to complete lap number 9 out of 11. Clampett is a full set sail, and you see right there, and Nate Stewart's day is going to be done for, unfortunately. Not really much to say. Clampett's just a full set sail in that MX-5 machine. Connor is now under attack by Nick Short. I'm currently tinkering around with OBS settings. Apologies if it stutters and such, but trying to get my best do my best to show you the best pictures here on the iRacing service. Dominic Howe back onto the racetrack as more lag. Apologies about that. A lot of stuttering as Nick Short goes to the low side around Connor. So that'll move Connor back to fifth place, or at least nearly. as they're side by side into the upcoming left-hander. Nick, wow, what a nice job to pinch Connor through that corner, and Nick goes up to fourth place. Nick is probably the fastest person out here on the racetrack, but no, he's not. Clampett still is. He's definitely making some time, but he's going to make some time on this second and third place, but I don't know if it's going to be good enough. Hello. Yeah, that was not good. I think it wasn't David. Don't know who that was, but it spun around. It's like a machine, a black car. Liam's gonna fall multiple positions, and that'd be the 21 of Austin Johnson. So Liam's eliminated from the race. Goes back to fourth. But leads it at 13. So, currently 13 minutes and 23 seconds remaining in the race as of right now. So, Cam hasn't made good gains on Clampett. Meanwhile, Nick Short and Connor Brandon have been going back and forward at it. See them, well, sort of through the trees as they appear right there. Looks like Short has taken the upper hand. Oh, getting a bit off track there. Derek M. Smith is now the fastest of these three. Started 4th place, now down to 6th. And booted down after that contact with a 92, I mean, overshot it into that sharp left-hander. But now I'm making some time up on Connor. So we'll see if Connor makes something up. Or can Derek go ahead and repass him and take advantage? It's like Delicato and Christopher Hoyo. Both of them are going to be doing it out for a top 10 position. Also in that mix is Kiloa Hankins in the 72. Kiloa doing a nice job. As they're going to go side by side to the right-hander. Who's going to give, who's not. Hard on the brakes. Nearly bit of contact as see that green Arizona, that teal Arizona machine. Apoyo doing a nice job of keeping with that car in front of him of Delicato. Boy, Apoyo got a run down the front stretch, so here goes, he's gonna peek out to the inside. That time by Delicato beat Poyo at the line. Not by much, as you see the 61 of Dominicao over the wall. Don't know what he's doing there. Probably flipped it over, unfortunately. So, fun seeing a lot of cars on, especially on this time, this racetrack. You don't see a lot, as you see the 72 Kiloa Hankins. Oh, that wasn't Kiloa Hankins. Don't know who that was, but they were off track. Back on it, and you see Johnson right a bit wide. Currently running in 20th place. Mullins waiting himself up to 17th. Now chasing down the 32, Jonathan Hernandez, David B. Smith, and William Schmidt. All these three. Boy, they're kind of a big battle for 14th place. You scroll up all the way to 77, Keaton Jones. And that was, there's Kiloa Hankins. Off track goes Poyo, and here's Dominic screwing around, being an eyesore to the camera, but whatever. Clampus has pulled himself up to a 6 second lead. Eben's been holding him off though. Short hasn't really gained as much ground up to third place. I'm pretty sure he just burned out all his tire and is now just going away on him. So Connor gonna settle in fifth unless he makes a mistake. There's Derek and there's Trey. Trey's actually battled in and he is now looking for oh, Derek's gonna peek to the inside, but he's momentarily in sixth place. Gonna be side by side into the final corner. Both on the brakes. Derek's a bit sideways. Gets a bit loose off. Trey gonna get the run on the high side. As they're side by side. It looks like Trey's gonna keep position. What a move by Trey. Both of them trying to outbrake each other coming into one. Derek has the upper hand on the inside and he's gonna take it. Back into sixth place, so. Clampett, in the meantime, is stuck, bottled in some lap traffic. Oh my god, no way. Yeah, Clampett has a 7 second lead, but he just got wrecked by a lap car. Who even was that? That was Dylan Simmons. Just overcorrected. Luckily for Clampett, I don't think that damage is going to do anything, but we're going to take... But he has a ton of damage on his front end, like... Oh my goodness. That has probably destroyed his car. And now this will put Cam Evan And Burrows up into this mix, and Clampett is now falling off. Oh god. There's Clampett. Yeah, since Clampett's damaged. Oh gosh. You see how much braking and how torn up his car is. His toe is knocked out. His toe is definitely knocked out. They're gaining too much on him. Clampett sideways. Four laps to go. Can Clampett hold on? Yeah, he's destroyed. He's destroyed. Oh my god. Yeah, Eben and Burrows are there. Clampett goes into the corner. Takes it deep. Has to. His toe's knocked out. And Eben and Burrows is there. This is gonna become a three-way battle for the lead. Clamp is just gonna tow it out. Just got out of the way of the... Got out of the way of the leaders. And you're gonna take three laps to go. Unbelievable. Coming to two to go. The pressure's on as suddenly Eben is in position to win it when he was just 6 seconds behind the 44 Clampett. Eben goes wide. And here comes Burrows. Boy, he's there. Both of them are all over the racetrack. Burrows actually lost a ton of time to Eben. And oh, Burrows gets sideways. I think that secures it. Eben's gonna go up and away with his, I think. Yeah, his second win of the season. Won the first one at Silverstone. Didn't compete really in the second one. Now as he makes himself into the final corner, Burrows with a slight bit of mistake. And he's now one lap away from victory. White flag. Minshew pulls it wide as they come to the white. Burrows is trying to do as much as he can. Can't do it as much. Cam Evans probably going to win this race. He makes himself through the final corners. Cam Evans with a good second lead over Anthony Burrows. A clear sail off of this final corner. And he's going to win his second race of the season. Congratulations. Off the final corner, Cam Evans gonna win it here at Summit Point. Bell for third going on right behind as well. Looks like, Nick Short takes third over Connor Brandon. Look around for the battle in fifth. That summarizes itself. Derek M. Smith in fifth place over Trey Shuttlesworth as they head through the final corner. Josh Patterson, Jackson Minshew. Minshew probably looking around to go ahead and sail it around the 0-2 as the 0-2 takes it wide and he's into the grass. Can Minshew get him at the line? Oh, Patterson sideways through and looks like he'll keep seventh place as he goes ahead and hits Minshew across the wire. You see Kilo Hankins right there. 77, and Keaton Jones is going to round out himself in 10th. In 4-11th place, 12th and 13th, this is Brian C. Mullen, William Schmidt, David B. Smith. And they're coming down onto the final corners. And one last right-hander from this point on. And Mullen looks like he's going to keep 11th, but looking around for 12th. David's going to sail it to the high side. Crossover. William's going to pull the block. They're crossing yet again, as they're side-by-side the start-finish line, William gonna get 12th at the line. And he's gonna ramp it just for a little, so congratulations to your winner, the 36, Cam Evans. So we'll be back right after this for commercial break as we're gonna interview the top three of Cam Evans, Anthony Burrows, and Nick Short.
Growing up as a kid in Oklahoma, where I'm from, the Chili Bowl is the biggest race that we have. The Chili Bowl has kind of been my favorite race of the year. Growing up a dirt racer in Oklahoma, that's kind of the holy grail.
We're back here live here for the Summit Point Sprint, obviously at Summit Point Raceway. And we're going to interview our top three of Cam Evan, Anthony Burrows, and Nick Short. Obviously going to drag the winner here first. And into the booth goes that 36 of Cam Evan. Cam, congratulations on the win, man. After Clampett had a bit of interaction with the lap car, you suddenly found yourself in position to win it, and you took advantage of it, and you picked up your second one, man. Congratulations. Talk to me about your run.
Yeah, definitely should not have won that race. Logan was extremely fast. I was a little bit closer at the beginning, but as the tires fell off, he was just a lot better. But unfortunately, I think Dylan Simmons sneezed, it appears, and took out Logan, and then, yeah, like you said, I just ended up in the right place at the right time.
Yeah, and you had to fend off the 62 of Anthony Burrows. He was coming fast, but fortunately, you round yourself in front of him, and you take your second win here tonight for the iSCAR Road Series. Congratulations, man. How'd you hold him off?
Well, we were working together for the majority of the race, trying to stay with Logan as long as we could, and otherwise just trying to pull away from the cars behind. I just defended the inside into turn one, and unfortunately he drove off out of the first corner, so that pretty much gave me a cushion to give me the victory.
Alright, man, congratulations for tonight's win, obviously picking up your second here tonight for the iSCAR Road Series. Any sponsors you'd like to thank for tonight?
I'd just like to thank my team, Asbury Motorsports, and the Wolf Pack for supporting me along this journey.
Alright, man, 10-4, congratulations, man. Can't wait to talk coming next week.
Alright, thank you.
Alright, and that was the 36 of Cam Evan, and we're going to slide in to the booth of the 62 of Anthony Burrows. And Burrows, again, the interaction with the lap car and Clampett, suddenly you find yourself in position to win it, but unfortunately, a late race mishap happened, and you find yourself in second. Anything you could have done different to go ahead and pick up the win tonight?
Yeah, definitely. I think with two to go, I went to the outside of Cam and kind of overdrove the corner and got stuck out in the grass and couldn't get back on track. And at that point, I was pretty much out of his draft and couldn't really do anything. So, to come away with second place isn't too bad, though. So, congrats to Cam on the win.
Yeah, man, it was a hectic start. As soon as you hit the throttle coming into one, and what you see out of your mirror other than a snake of cars coming right at you?
I don't even know.
Paying attention to the front windshield?
Yeah, pretty much.
Alright, man, 10-4. And you started third, ended up second. And otherwise than that, any sponsors to take for tonight's race?
Shout out to the Wolf Pack for giving me good cars week in and week out. Congrats to Cam again on the win.
Alright, man, 10-4. Can't wait to come. Can't wait to see you coming next week, man. That was Anthony Burrows in second place, and we're going to slide into the booth, our final third place finisher, the number 93 of Nick Short. And Nick, you obviously rallied yourself from 21st, and you crawled yourself all the way to third. Started towards the back half of the field, and what was it like crawling yourself through the traffic?
Nerve-wracking. I was trying to make sure I didn't get collected in anything. I did kind of cause an incident with the, I believe the 21. But, no, I was just trying to get through the field as quick as I possibly could because I knew I had the pace in qualifying. I'd started a lap, but I didn't finish it. I knew I had the pace to be up front. I just basically was starting 21st. So yeah, I tried the best I could and just ended up kind of in no man's land, P3.
Yeah, but obviously a great rally. All the way from 21st to 3rd place. But if you did log in a lap, do you think you would have had a chance there? Maybe a shot at the win?
Probably a shot at 2nd if Clampett didn't get wrecked. He was flying. He was, I think, race lap-wise, because I was talking to Cam and Anthony, I think he was about 5, 6, 7 tenths faster a lap, which is just insane. But he's a pro driver for a reason, so you should expect that. And Cam and Anthony got a little bit lucky with Dylan doing whatever he did. I didn't see it, but I heard it was quite silly. And I think I could have had a shot with Clampett being out, but with him still in there, no.
Yeah, but you'll take a third place any day, man. Congratulations. Any sponsors to thank for a night's race?
Yeah, I'd like to thank, well, I don't really have sponsors, but I'd like to thank my, well, the Wolfpack team. They are legends and are a fictional Wolfpack team. And my yellow and orange MX-5.
All right, man, 10-4. Congratulations on third place, man. I can't wait to come you talk to you coming next week.
Yeah, see ya.
And that was Nick Short running himself out in third place. And that will be all here for tonight. Thank you for watching for the Summit Point Sprint. Congratulations to 36 of Cam Evan to pick up his second here tonight. And unfortunate for the 44 of Logan Clampett for getting wrecked out. So we'll be back, same time slot. Obviously a bit late for this one, but fortunately we got the race up and away. But congratulations to 36. This is KMN. My name is Zeke Reyes, and we're signing out. Peace out.